So I'll do all the letters, and the next round you can do all the letters. How about that?
I'm really not bothered about choosing, to be honest.
Well, all I am. Can I have a consonant, please, Carol?
Actually, I want.
Sorry, that's. Can I have a consonant, please, Rich?
W.
W.
An F.
No, an F. I need an F.
If you never see.
What is it?
You not got a monitor?
Oh, yeah, we do. We got.
Can't we look at this? Oh. Jim, didn't realise. Jim, you're an idiot. I thought that was a little borrower that has got trapped in a shoe.
I thought if you got bored, it was something else on.
It's hard for me to watch you on a screen because usually when I'm doing that, I have to shut the curtains. Oh, this has descended so far. Come on, M. Consonant, please. If it's an M, we're in.
G.
Oh, I hope we've got a G and a Y and a tits.
OK, what have you got? What's your nine-letter word, Lee Mack?
Steadings.
Oh, amazing. It's in.
All or nothing. I'm very much a multiple of three person. I've
been
doing a six.
Be honest, Julie, are you as surprised as everyone else? And that is a word.
On the outside, I'm trying to look cool. Inside, I'm going, I can't believe it. This reminds me of the first time I had sex.
Please.
I'm going, how the hell did that happen?
What does it mean?
What does it mean? Well, you put your penis inside a.
Can we just do the fucking conundrum?
Yeah, do the conundrum. I'm quite good with nine-letter ones. You won't let me know if I'm getting too cocky, won't you? I'm not going, no, gauge me.
Brilliant exchange of nine ones this time.
I'll just
Let's have two big ones this time, can we?
Two big ones? Yeah, yeah, you can change
Maybe
your mind.
Maybe instead of one of the little ones.
This is like being with Jimmy Savile at a pick and mix.
So have you got a mascot this evening, Lee?
I have got a mascot, yes.
What have you got?
I brought along, this is genuinely true, I've actually brought along my nan's ashes. And genuinely true, my nan was always a big fan of Countdown and she always wanted to come on. And so this is like.
is that
genuinely my nan's ashes.
It's not, though, is it?
It really is. And
can we have a look?
Don't joke about with it because it's genuinely real.
Oh.
Literally, it's a whole head just pushed in, which is not nice to see.
She had a lovely smile on her face.
She did, yeah. There's actually a funny story connected with this. She died and we cremated her. That's it.
If she died in a fire, you would have got a discount.
Jimmy, that's my man you're talking about.
No, but that's freaking me out.
That freaks out. You should have seen her when she was alive with a flick knife and a bottle of vodka.
What have you got?
Whose book was that?
That was the Lee Mack biography.
What's that? What have you done?
Nothing. I was reading it, but once I read it, I was just drawing the evidence.
It's not like you to be shredding paperwork in case you get followed on with.
Now time for Lee and John to go head-to-head. This numbers round is just for them. OK, John, you're to pick the numbers.
Come on, Nana!
You're not going to revive her, Lee.
This is the one. She better bring me some luck.
OK, Lee.
422.
Lee! How did you do it?
Right, you take that 422 at the top. Write that down. Don't touch it with any of the other numbers. I haven't got anything again, you useless bitch! Sorry, I've been under a lot of stress since she died.
Well, that was it, was it?
I got nothing. Sorry.
You were writing stuff. You've put minus 8 there, 66 there, you've got, and 78. Where's that from?
That's when she died.
That makes sense now, yeah.
Let's have a little recap of the score. So at the moment, John and Adam are in the lead. They have 53 points. Bob and Lee have no points.
Yeah, but we've both got active sex lives, so fuck them.
OK. Lee, last time you were on the show, you got no points. No one's ever done that before.
Why don't we talk about the previous series where I got a nine-letter word and John missed it? Why don't we talk about that?
Steddings.
Steddings, thank you very much. Well, I'm not going to go on about it because that would be arrogance, which is another nine-letter word, just so you know.
John, on the last episode of Cats Countdown, you got the highest score ever recorded on Countdown, 153.
Yeah.
Happy with that?
So happy. It's not the size of my score, but the size of Lee's score. I mean...
Oh, you are such a fuckstick.
Nine letters.
Where do you think Lee's weaknesses are?
The words and the letters. The wardrobe, that's a problem.
I think that's rich coming from a Mancunian. Nine letters. Probably the worst insult I've done so far.
By about 80 miles.
Where are you from?
Lancaster, yeah.
Nine letters. Anyway, you put the German one in the middle, but it should be on the far right.
Lee, you've got an eight-letter word?
I have.
OK, what is it?
Dyslexic. Could you find us a H in the consonants?
It might be a bit bigger, but there'll be one in here somewhere.
You want an H?
Yeah.
We can actually make you an... Oh, hang on.
Oh, my God. Oh.
You're going to be careful doing that, because you get helicopters landing everywhere. Does that look OK?
Yeah.
Can I adjust that? I'm a bit anal with that. I've got to see the A as well.
OK, there we go.
I love the idea that someone's just tuning in now going, my right eye is knackered.
OK. Lee, have you got a mascot?
I have got a mascot, Jimmy. Yes,
excellent.
I have got
news.
A mascot. At first, I was thinking of using you, because I recently watched all your DVDs and I thought, you are the luckiest man I know. I changed my mind and I brought with me my lucky wishbone. It's my little lucky wishbone. And a funny story behind this, actually. This is the wishbone that my nan choked on and I inherited her house. Look at it. So, pop that there. And think of Nan.
It is edible. I mean, you can put it in your mouth, but I mean, we don't know what the repercussions are going to be. We'll find out.
Another one of Jimmy's chat up lines.
It's time for today's crucial Countdown conundrum.
Oh, sorry, I've started. I was going to go for Downton.
And your time starts now. Lee.
Well, I don't know if this is right, it might be wrong. So what I'm going to go for is... I know it! It is...
Start the clock again!
Can I go again?
Yeah.
It's me!
Can we not stop the clock?
Bim!
Stop the
clock!
Stop the frigging clock!
Is it Birmingham?
Renumbering.
No, it's numbering.
Numbering, that's what I meant. Numbering. Please leave it in here. Numbering, sorry.
Sorry, as a stickler for the rules.
No. It's numbering, and I'm having it. It doesn't matter, we've won anyway. It doesn't matter, because they can't capture us. Whatever, don't care. Who needs a hammer?
Are we giving them the 10?
Are we giving them the 10? Says the referee finger that lives in his ear.
If you were in the 10.
Oh, you little finger. Come on, give me a straight answer. You'll go up the nose. We don't need it. We're 2 points ahead. But take your 10 and stick it where the sun don't shine. Give me the handle and let's just get the news on.
OK. Lee, have you got a mascot?
I know on this show you like options, so I'll give you two. You can choose which one you want. No, I haven't got a mascot, Jimmy, because I think it's a pagan ritual. You know, the whole superstition thing goes against the teachings of the Bible and Jesus Christ. Or, yes, Jimmy, I have. I've brought my lucky penis. I'll rub it throughout the show.
And I know that Lee's actually unexpectedly gifted at some of the word games.
What? Sorry, sorry. Whoa, whoa, whoa. The word I'm focusing on is unexpectedly.
They meant northern.
It's not about you being northern. Just your whole demeanour.
My whole demeanour?
Yeah.
Right. Get the letters out and watch this, dickhead.
Have you got a mascot?
Yes, Jimmy. I brought my lucky restraining order. This is my restraining order that Susie Dent got against me. But she doesn't realise it expired 2 days ago, so... got to look at it. So, I like the fact that the props department have made me this restraining order with a pink ribbon round it, like... restraining orders come like a certificate that you've graduated. tell you that you have to keep 500 metres away from Susie Dent. You filled it in. That is a lot. Restraining order. Lee Mack, full name, Susie Dent. Write these numbers down on your pad.
Shut up. No, only use them once.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And a bit like certain guests on this show.
Make the numbers up.
No, only use them once.
Oh, shut up.
Okay, Lee, who would be, I mean, Bob Mortimer accepted, who would be your dream partner on this show?
Now you ask me. who would be my dream? Can it be anyone from history?
Yeah, anyone from history, yeah.
Sean McKenzie. He used to sit behind me in history.
OK, John, have you got a mascot?
I've been in my lab a lot lately. Yeah. Been down in my lab.
I hope you don't mean your dog.
She'll rephrase that to avoid any ambiguity. I've been right up my spaniel the last couple of months.
There once was a fat kid called Jimmy. who went all showbiz and got skinny. His white teeth are drastic. His wig's made of plastic. and his money's kept offshore in New Guinea.
Rachel, you held this for me earlier.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
So that hopefully that will give me some power to do the maths and therefore not let down John.
When Jonathan said, "Will you pop into my dressing room and hold my spoon?" Were you nervous?
Yeah. Oh, I took a chaperone.
I'm not as nervous as when I said I brought my lucky penis.
Lee, have you got a mascot?
Yeah, I've got a mascot, Jimmy.
What have you got?
I've actually got a framed picture of Mr. Braithwaite, my headmaster.
Mr. Braithwaite.
Mr. Braithwaite, and this is the actual frame photo he had in his office. Well, it was just it was next to the TV and video, which I also nicked. I sort of used this Mr. Braithwaite picture, or Mr. Braithwaite the bastard, as we used to affectionately call him, as a sort of daily motivation. You know, he always said I'd amount to nothing, and nothing would become of my life, and I couldn't make it in life. And you know, if you're watching Mr. Braithwaite, I just want you to know that. You know, I'm here on Countdown, and you said I was rubbish at everything, I wouldn't amount to anything. I don't know why I'm saying all this, of course, you died 15 years ago. but, you know, if I can rub it in the face of his widow, then... something, innit?
Lee used to work at Butlin's, our dated...
Poltons! I don't mind a joke, Jimmy, but don't get me started.
I'm so sorry.
Pontins.
I think the joke's still going to work.
I work for everyone else, not for me, because I'll be crying on the inside. carry on. Get it right this time.
OK. Lee used to work at Pontins, outdated, cheap and loved by old people. Lee's a national treasure.
Victoria, have you got a mascot?
Oh, hang on, I forgot this one. This is quite a good joke. Ready for this? Quite a good joke, this. I've even got a very old one. This is Shakespeare's actually chewed pencil. It's so chewed, I can't tell whether it's 2B or not 2B. I don't need to be here. I have the love of the job. Not because I've got tax bills that haven't been paid for 10 years. So don't have to do that with me. I've been on the Jeff Dunn Polish show. You're not laughing now, but I guarantee that'll be the one that you wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning and go, to me or not to me. I will anyway. Then I'll turn around and I'll go, do you know what I said tonight, love? Oh, you left me years ago, didn't you?
I like the way I came on and no one even noticed that I'd massive fucking tits. No one even noticed.
Welcome to my life.
I'm quite booby as well. I can see if I can do it. We could form a boy band, Lactate That. Too pretty or not to be!